Now, it must be noted that while France kept the guillotine up until the late 1970s, September 10th, 1977 to be exact, public executions ended 38 years earlier on June 17th, 1939, when Eugene Weidman was sentenced for the conviction of 6 murders. While Weidman was being led up to the guillotine and assumed the position, the crowd of rowdy Parisians cheered, booed, yelled, and basically enjoyed themselves way too much. Someone in the crowd even secretly filmed the whole thing. And that's when the French government put an end to the viewing parties. After Weidman, all of France's guillotine activity took place in private in the prison courtyard. This solved 2 problems. 1, the executioners could rely on a working guillotine. With every use, French prison employees would have to build and tear down their guillotine, like overworked carnies at the county fair. Because of this, it wasn't uncommon for the guillotine to malfunction every now and then. It wasn't unheard of for a trigger to snap apart or an unaligned blade to produce a sloppy severing. A permanent guillotine could be regularly maintained and calibrated, making the act a bit more predictable, if not much more efficient. The other problem it served, the crowds were getting wild in the streets. Local bars filled up with spectators, pre-gaming before the beheading. Building owners with views looking out onto the action sold window seats to those who wanted a bird's-eye view of the proceedings. Kids would be hanging off nearby tree branches in hopes of getting a glimpse. The French government, along with prison employees, realized the guillotine had officially become bigger and much more of a headache, yes, pun intended, than they ever estimated. How did the public find out? Notices were posted around town announcing the time and place. Sometimes the prison would give their version of a press release to the local newspaper with the scheduling information. And sometimes the times weren't announced and crowds would just gather around prison employees assembling a guillotine in the middle of a road. By the late 1930s, guillotine fans earned a violent reputation, much like football hooligans. The prison staff would be forced to assemble their guillotine in the middle of the night, then do the deed early in the morning in the hopes of avoiding bloodthirsty crowds. But it never worked. The guillotine always drew a big crowd.